Hi everyone, welcome back to Bella Cooks, where today we're going to be making sada and also boko. As we are rolling into our video, I'm going to be showing you the ingredients that we're going to be needing to be creating this recipe. So I chose the meat osobuco just because mainly of its flavor, as well as the fact that it's very good with stews. So for this recipe where I'm going to be adding vegetables to the meat, it's going to be a very good sort of meat that I will need for this recipe. Now when it comes to cutting the osobuco, I just want to make sure that I cut off the excess meat and just leave some meat on the bone. I then go in with various spices that I have, just to make sure that by the end of the meat cooking, my stock that's left behind after boiling the meat is gonna be full of flavor. And I need that just to add back to the meat and the vegetables at the end of the recipe. Now you don't have to put every spice that I've showcased, but you can put whatever you have in your pantry. It can be 2 to 3 spices, but as I said, I just want my meat to be full of flavor, and that's why I chose quite complementary spices. Next up is just adding water to the meat and then putting it by the stove. Now next, I'm gonna be cutting up my kale. Kale is a very good vegetable to go with sada as well as beef, especially with the fact that we're gonna be combining our vegetables with the meat. Next is just cutting up the onions and just making sure that I dice them into finer pieces. Then going in with the tomatoes, I will be adding these two to the vegetables. Now that my osobuco is tender and well cooked, it's now time to be frying it a little bit. So I first of all add a little bit of olive oil. Then I transfer the osobuco to that hot oil. As soon as I'm done doing that, you can see that my stock was left in the pot. I've just transferred it to a smaller bowl. Now coming in with the onions. As soon as they are soft, I go in and add my vegetables. Now, some people can end at this stage and just have the vegetables together with the meat. But because I was just being lazy and wanted to have everything in one pot, I further went on to add the rest of the other ingredients into this mixture. So I went in with the tomatoes. And then just make sure that I give it a good stir and that everything is well combined. Next in, I'm going to add about 2.5 tablespoons to 3 tablespoons of the tomato paste. I will also add Royco, which is an African powdered soup. And now with that stock that is full of all those flavors, I'm going to be adding that to my vegetable mixture. Now you can just have your soup just combining your meat, so that it's not excess soup into the meat, or you can actually cover your whole pot with the soup. So for me, I just wanted it to be a bit on the thickened side as well combined. Now I'm just going in with a bit of French onion soup and just leave that to the boil. And now that's pretty much it. Now we go on to make our salsa. And as you can see, the first step is just to add a cup of the flour, or should I say a cup of the hufu or millet meal. And then you add cold water, then you add boiling water, bring it to the boil, and it should be bubbling the way that is bubbling in the video. When it's been bubbling like that for a good 10 to 15 minutes, it's up for adding more of the millet meal. You keep on adding little bits of the millet meal up until the mixture is becoming a bit more thickened. Then after that, just give it a good, should I say, a good beating. When it's cooked, it's now time to do my plating. So I've just covered my plate with cling wrap so that the salsa will really flow into the plate. Now I'm just adding the osobuco mixture, lining up my meat so that it looks so beautiful to presentation. And that's it, guys. That's pretty much what I made, the osobuco with some salsa. This was definitely a very yummy meat mixture, and my daughter really loved it. And she ate her salsa. She doesn't like salsa, but she really ate salsa this time. Thank you everyone for watching. Please make sure to share, like, subscribe, and put a comment in my comment section to let me know what you'd want to watch. Thank you so much for watching. Have a good one. Bye.